Watch out for headbutt, back of the head and spine. I want a clean, fair fight. Touch grab if you want. Back your corner.
It's an atomweight contest between Filipino six-time national wushu champion Gina Iniong and Japanese deep jewels featherweight champion Mei Yamaguchi.
Just time.
The look. Ready? Ready? Of intensity on Yamaguchi this week around the hotel, in media interviews, in open workouts. I've never seen Mei look more focused, more determined. She wants that crack, that rematch for the title in 2018. And she's got to get past Gina Iniong, and Iniong's got one big prime weapon, Mitch. That's the straight right cross of the Filipino.
Yeah, she has a beautiful straight right hand that comes off like a trip hammer. Extremely powerful, but also very fast. And you can see Mei Yamaguchi likes to come in close. She likes to close the distance. She's a point player.
Clinching up for the first time, it's Iniong who presses Mei against the cage. Yamaguchi has never lost a rematch. She is 3-0-1 in rematches. Since she worked on her boxing, on her grappling in preparation for this one. Iniong says she's got to watch out for Yamaguchi's ground game, has to be very vigilant on the submissions. Says she exposes Mei Yamaguchi in the striking. And says, I believe Mei is open to my right cross. Yamaguchi predicted a second round choke win. Iniong didn't pick a round, but said it'll be either a TKO or a decision. Nice corking knees here from Gina Iniong.
But look at the position, Michael, that she's holding her in. She's got double underhooks on Mei Yamaguchi. She's pressing her up against the cage, and there's nowhere for her to go. Now she's trying to spin off, but look at the pressure that Iniong is applying up against the cage. She's landing these knees. I think these knees are starting to bother her, Michael.
Having competed only 2 weeks ago, you've got to ask the question, should this one get to the third round, how will the gas tank of Gina Iniong hold up tonight?
Oh, I think it's going to hold up tremendously well, because she trains out there at altitude with Team Lakai in Baguio City, Philippines. So the entire team has a huge gas tank, and stamina is rarely a problem.
With the champion here, outside Mitch Angela Lee, does that spur on Mei Yamaguchi that little bit more, knowing Angela's right here, a few feet away, watching her?
It's got to, because you can get inside the mind of your opponent if you put on a tremendous display of athletic ability. With one big punch, with one big kick, you can easily secure yourself that rematch. That she's got. Nice little pull guard there. She didn't want to get in too entangled in that, but she did a butterfly sweep.
Exactly where Yamaguchi wants to be. Top position with Gina Iniong on her back. And you see Iniong wisely closing the guard, trying to control the posture. Doesn't want the ground and pound coming through here from Mei Yamaguchi.
Iniong's trying to trap that arm and throw up an arm bar. She's trying to pivot her hips out, but you can see Yamaguchi's the hips with her hips. Throwing up that arm bar.
Powerful elbows off the left arm from Yamaguchi.
Tries to create a little bit of space by pushing the hips away, but Yamaguchi gets right back on top.
We are seeing two halves of the contest so far. On the feet, it was Gina Iniong. On the ground, it's Mei Yamaguchi
in control. Watch out
the
head. Time.
Illegal up kick there from Gina Iniong, Mitch.
Yeah, we had two knees down. We had over 3 points with a full weight on the knees. Rich, how did you see that one?
Accidental kick. She kind of realized what she did after she did it. A little bit of an apology. I don't think they're going to take full time out here. They'll probably get the back to action real quick.
It looks like the knee, possibly she was kicking the body, but it slid up to the chin. Maybe it was inadvertent, most likely completely inadvertent.
And there's the champion, Angela Lee, as we said here, cage side, recovering from a car accident a few weeks ago, which sidelined her for tonight. She was meant to face Mei Yamaguchi. The winner of this one will be the number one contender, we believe, in 2018 to take on Angela Lee. And here's the illegal upkick, Mitch.
Yeah, it looks like maybe just some of the toes caught her on the chin there. She was trying to kick her in the chest, but maybe just some of the toes got her there in the chin.
Referee Olivia Coase gets us back underway here in the first round. Now, on the feet is where Conviction Gina Iniong has been impressive so far. She's got to try and avoid going to ground with Mei Yamaguchi.
But we got to keep in mind that Mei Yamaguchi's got a third-degree black belt in karate, so she's got a nice, you can see it, she's got that nice wide stance. Her hands are low, perfectly placed kind of for that big right hand of Iniong.
A karate guy in the stand-up versus a six-time national wushu champion. You've got to watch out for the right hand, the straight right hand of Gina Iniong. Iniong trying to press Yamaguchi against the cage here. Under a minute remaining in the opening round.
You can just see how strong Iniong is. There's no place for Yamaguchi to go except right there. She realizes that's her biggest weapon in that clinch is to pull guard. Now she's got the butterfly hooks, so maybe we can look for that same sweep she did earlier.
And Iniong did say she might get a takeover by a ground and pound. Gotta be careful of them.
There's that same sweep she has. She likes to pull guard, get the butterfly hooks in, elevate the hips of Iniong, and end up on top.
Gina Iniong on her back. One butterfly hook on the left leg. Now feet on hips, now throws the legs up, maybe hoping to lock up the arm of Yamaguchi. Gina Iniong hunts for a submission in the final stages, but won't get it. We go to the towel.
There's the clinch, nice knee again. Yamaguchi was able to pull guard. Here you can see the butterfly hooks go in. She elevates that right side, ends up with a beautifully timed sweep. She did it twice in that round. That's gotta score in a variety of categories. You can see her do it again right here. She has the overhook on one side, elevates the hips, butterfly sweep to end up on top. Interesting round. Rich, break that one down for him.
Look, I'm gonna focus on the ground control for this particular scoring. This isn't indicative of the entire match this first round, but Mei Yamaguchi's definitely winning the ground control. She's taking the fight to the ground. I'm not scoring takedowns on that, but she's able to reverse, land some ground and pounds from the top position, which definitely outscores the damage that Gina is doing from the clinch position with the knee. So at this point in time, I have Mei ahead on the scorecards. Slightly.
Capacity crowd inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium for one championship, another sellout. And wherever you're watching, 128 countries, potentially over 1 billion people worldwide. We hope you're enjoying all the action. So much at stake here for Mei Yamaguchi and Gina Iniong. Could determine the number one contender for the atomweight title in 2018. Iniong two-punch combination. Little fakes and feints there from Yamaguchi as she edges forward. High on the balls of her feet, that wider karate stance. Shoots in for a single leg, a low single, wraps the hands around the back of the knee, switches to a
I was expecting her to punch into the clinch and probably jump guard again, but she went in and attacked the single leg, and now she's sitting in the half guard of Iniong.
Something you don't see a lot outside of Japan these days, the single leg takedown. It was always the Kazushi Sakuraba special, of course, the low single leg. We saw Yamaguchi switch from a single to a double, now inside the half guard position. She can do some damage from here, Mei Yamaguchi. What should Gina Iniong be looking to do here, Mitch?
Gina Iniong's got to create a little bit of space. Right now, see how she's got her hand, that left hand on the chin there? She can start to frame away and create a little bit of space, but she spins underneath, gets that underhook on that side. Now she can create a little bit more space, but you can see Yamaguchi trying to flatten Iniong out onto the mat, now delivering a little bit of ground and pound. You can see how Inyong's trying to dive under and attack that leg to possibly swivel up and create a little bit of a transition here. She's trying to suck that leg in. She may be able to reverse the position here.
Latching onto a single leg here is Gina Iniong.
Heavy sprawl from Yamaguchi keeps the legs as far away from Iniong as possible, but she has an outside trip.
Iniong almost back to her feet, now looking for top position. Can she keep holding her back? No, Mei gets top position.
She's using her butterfly hooks very well, how she takes the insides of her shin and kind of sticks her feet underneath the legs of Iniong, and that's given her that control where she's able to reverse the positions.
We said earlier that Mei Yamaguchi is undefeated in rematches, 3-0-1. Well, this is Gina Iniong's first ever rematch. Full mount coming here, yes, from Mei Yamaguchi. Dominant position from the Japanese athlete. Can she take the back here?
Gotta be careful, bridging out. She extended that arm. Hook is able to control the position of Iniong.
Some seesawing on the ground. Yamaguchi top position once more. Works the right hand to the body, then to the head. What should Gina be looking to do from here, Mitch?
You can see she has her left leg across the stomach of Yamaguchi, so she's trying to create a little bit more space, but she also doesn't want to let Yamaguchi do any more ground and pound, because that seems to be bothering her a little bit, so she's pulling her head in as well. So here she can probably dive under and possibly sweep as well, but I think Yamaguchi's onto that, so she's gotta create some space and start to scramble.
Iniong training with the likes of Edward Filiang, Honorio Benario, Kevin Ballingon, star-studded team at Lakai. Side control now for Mei Yamaguchi. She did predict, once again, a second round submission by a choke.
Americana attempt right here. You can see the shoulder lock that she's trying to lock into that position right there. But Iniong does the right thing, but she's got to turn the other way and start moving.
Yamaguchi looking to go to work on that far arm again.
But to finish.
Looking to pin the right arm though. Amphis drops to the press basket there of Gina Iniong.
Again, another Americana attempt. She's here trying to pin down the left arm.
Neon Bally, more aggressive position. Now it's the full mount. No, she switches to the opposite side of the body. Head arm choke coming here. Mei Yamaguchi turning. Can she find it? Can she step out? Gina Iniong. 30 seconds to go in the round. Gina holding on. Mei applies the vice like pressure. Squeezing. Turning. 20 seconds now. It's survival for Gina Iniong. Looks like Gina Iniong is going to survive the round.
Interesting defense from Gina Iniong for that arm triangle. She was pushing with her right hand on her left hand to create a little bit of space so the choke couldn't get in deep. Not the best technique as far as defending your arm triangle, but it worked.
Mitch, I've got to ask the question again. She's taken some punishment by a ground and pound in that second round. How do you think the gas tank is holding up on Gina Iniong, who once again competed only 2 weeks ago?
Just a few weeks ago, she was in Manila and she had a really good contest. But we gotta wonder, I mean, I just think we're seeing the ground superiority play out here, and Yamaguchi's able to control this match on the ground. Rich, do you see it the same way?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Mei's doing a great job of controlling on the ground. I'll be honest, I was a little disappointed in her ability to actually accumulate damage as that round went on, until I saw a couple of those knees at about a minute left, and then she landed that arm triangle. I actually scored her in a near submission for that, which puts her even higher on the scoring category. So in the last minute of that round, she really just extended her lead significantly.
Sellout crowd inside the Singapore indoor arena. Third and final round. It is still anyone's bout for the taking here between Gina Iniong and Mei Yamaguchi. Big overhand right to open up the round from Mei. Want to see Iniong get her right hand off. Got a big reach advantage here. Some 5 centimeters taller is Gina Iniong. Can she keep the contest standing?
That right hand is her best weapon. You see the way she jumped into that right hand and then slid right out of the way? Goes and dives in for a double leg. Nice wizard defense there from Iniong.
Into the bread basket. Look at that. Pull guard again there, perhaps, was Mei Yamaguchi trying to get Iniong to come down to the ground. And Iniong does a little pirouette and gets out of trouble.
Iniong still looks light on her feet. She's still moving around really well, nice and relaxed. I don't think the gas tank is her problem. I just think the ground superiority and her being controlled on the ground is the biggest flaw in this possible contest.
Leads him with a stiff jab there. Does Yamaguchi.
She's like a fencer, Michael. She just jumps in, spears with a punch, and then gets right out of the way.
Fakes the right hand, goes for a hit kick, didn't have the torque behind it. And takes an incidental groin strike. There's Yamaguchi. She'll get some recovery time here. And Olivia Costa will send Gina Iniong to a neutral part of the cage. Okay, Mitch, let's play coach for a moment. We've only the third round remaining. If you're in the corner of Mei Yamaguchi, what are you telling the Japanese athlete to do?
Right now, she's doing everything right. Now, we're finally starting to see in this third round, she's landing some superior striking ability. She's jumping in, she's landing some shots, she's getting out of the way, and you can see that when she does get into the clinch, that's where she's able to initiate her ground attacks. She's pulling guards, sweeping to get up on top.
What about Gina Iniong? Because as we said, Yamaguchi on the ground has been dominant. What does Gina need to do?
Gina's got to kind of go for broke in this case. She's really starting to get to put together some big strikes and hurt Yamaguchi. She has to throw caution to the wind at these times. I'd like to see her with a lead push kick. A lot of these jumping side kicks, we're not seeing any of the lower body kicks.
You just get that feeling that Gina Iniong could land that power-laden right hand at any time, and she goes for it there.
But that's all she's doing. Strikes she's throwing occasionally with the hook. She's thrown like maybe one or two kicks the entire match.
Counter right hand there from Mei Yamaguchi, and Gina Iniong floats back to center cage.
You can see with the wide stance of Yamaguchi, that leg is prime. It's right there. It's a huge target for some leg kicks.
Although we saw Gina slow down with the use of the right hand in the second round, we can see her picking up again here in the third. She knows that's the prime weapon. She knows if she's going to knock out Yamaguchi tonight, it's going to be with either the straight right or the short overhand right.
You can see Mark Sangrio trying to get her animated, trying to keep her in this match. And these guys, they never have, the Lakai athletes never have a problem with gas. They have huge gas tanks, but she's got to go.
At the same time, Yamaguchi on her strikes has to make sure she doesn't overextend herself, because Iniong can counter and counter effectively. Yamaguchi looks for the inside thigh kick. Iniong fakes the right hand. 1 minute remains in the third and final round. There's the right hand from Gina Iniong. Just didn't have the starch behind it. The crowd want to see more of the right hand from Gina. And now Yamaguchi looks to take her down.
She's trying. She's got that single leg, but good defense from Iniong. Now she's got to fight the body lock. She's taken down, and she lands inside control.
Dominant position now for Mei Yamaguchi with 35 seconds remaining in this contest. The left hand goes to work for Mei Yamaguchi. This is where she's been so dominant. This is where she's had control every time it's gone to ground, Mitch.
Yeah, and you can just see that she's very, very comfortable in this position. But I'd like to see her possibly work to the finish. She's been so dominant in that position. She could really put a punctuation on this possibly number one contender bout and really secure her spot in the title hunt.
She's doing some punctuating with those knees. I'll tell you what, those right knees to the body and head of Gina Iniong. Now knee on belly from Yamaguchi. My word, Mei Yamaguchi bringing it home strongly here. Pops her head up, pulls it up. Shoot punch combination on the ground and pound from Yamaguchi. All over Gina Iniong on the canvas. Yamaguchi just dominant here. Short elbows, right hands. Iniong struggling to find a way back to her feet. Is Yamaguchi going to allow her up? Last chance here for Iniong. Has she got one big salvo left? One big right hand perhaps from Gina. Mei edges forward. Got a static right hand range. There's an uppercut attempt there from Gina. And she find a Hail Mary shot. Gina Iniong. Final 10 seconds. If it's going to come, it's going to come now. Looking for a takedown again. Yamaguchi, single leg. And there it is. We go to the judges. A battle that could very well have determined the number one contender to face that woman, the Atomweight World Champion, Angela Lee. Wild black right hand there from Gina. Here's the grounded pound from Mei Yamaguchi. The knees, the hammer fist strikes. Good posture up there. Two punches landing. Who will secure it? Really was a contrast of styles in the stand-up. It went the way of Iniong on the ground and went to Yamaguchi. Rich Franklin, let's get your thoughts on who you think won this one.
Mei Yamaguchi dominated every category of that match. You know, she was a bit more aggressive, and that picked up towards the end of the match. She was landing takedowns at the end. Great ground control. You can see it with the ground and pound. She had a near submission with the arm triangle. I scored her in damage. She was scoring high in every category and walked away with this fight.
Okay, to find out who won, let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we now turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by way of unanimous decision from the red corner, Mei Yamaguchi.